A quick video on the use of point and figure charts alongside of or superimposed upon your regular charts. I don't do this for everything, but on major indices like the SPX, the cash, or spiders, or the Russell, and so forth, you'll see these same horizontal lines on GTO's charts as you will on mine. Now, I've been using point and figure charts for quite some time. It's actually the first thing I learned back in 1987 when I first started trading. We used to get these books once a month from a company called Chartcraft. And you get these books and you would trade off of them. Basically, the X's are buys and the O's are selling. So you have this column of X's and a column of O's. And what that does, it filters out the noise, because an X cannot fill a box until that actual number is hit. So 1257.30 would have to be hit before that number would fill an X or a buy. And as we move up, it would fill the next box at 1294.40 once that number was actually traded. Now, there's a system where you see 347. This is the third month, or March, April, and then you have July. July we saw a high, and then we had a reversal. A three-box reversal is considered normal on a point and figure chart. And because of that high, we now have a line established of resistance where prices came up and then reversed. And as we reversed, you see this 8 and 9. This is August and September. Now, the numbers, because they can't fit a 10, 11, or 12 in a box, goes to A, B, and C. So this is October, November, and December, and we had a December high. Now, the most important thing to, well, one of the most important things to remember is when you see a reversal, that becomes your new support and resistance. Okay, in this case, July of 1999 was resistance, and you can start to draw your horizontal line for resistance or support if we got above it, like we did here in 1999. Okay, so then the good thing about this is, because it filters out the noise, only prices will fill a box if it's traded. Okay, so it can trade between 1333.50 and 1371.60 and still not fill a box until it gets to this number. Now, this is an ATR chart, which means it figures in volatility, the average true range. So, you might ask yourself, well, why are these numbers so strange? Well, this is a traditional three-box reversal point and figure chart. In this case, each box represents 10 points. So, an X will only fill a box if it goes from 1390 to 1400 and from 1400 to 1410. Okay, we filled a box today at 1410. This column of X's denotes buying. Okay, note the trend line. Note that we've broken above that trend line and that we have a resistance up here at 1450 on this traditional three-box reversal chart. Now, let's take a look at an ATR chart. You can just select the method here, average true range, and we'll refresh this. Note the $10 increments. On an ATR chart, you can see that the increments are figured for you because of the volatility in the stock or in the market at 16.15 points per box. It has to trade at 1421.20 in order to fill this next box. Okay, we can see that is the high that we put in September, 9 being September. We made two more boxes. We got on a buy signal, but then we reversed. A three-box reversal is quite common, in which case you go 1, 2, 3 boxes. Alright, then you would fill these O's here, and that being October, A for October and November, and then we reversed and started back on this course in the opposite direction. We reversed course, and now we're seeing buying. Now, the other nice thing about point and figure charts is, I mentioned earlier that 1404 was put in way back in 1999. Alright, if we look at this chart, you can see in July of 1999, 7 for July, we were at that 1404 level. Now, because of the ATR volatility, this number has changed to 1409. But back when this number was originally figured, it was 1404, and that number stuck. Okay? I may not be 100% correct on that. If you are a point and figure specialist, you can point that out to me in the room if there's a glaring error. But for the most part, 1404 has been on the charts for some time. And you see that here, 1404. Okay, and you can see that once we reach a level of point and figure support and resistance, that's a likely area that you'll see the market turn. And you can see every time we've come up to that level or close to it, we've turned and moved in the opposite direction. We found support here at 1304 around that area, came back up to the 1332 area, found resistance, and then moved lower. Now there's a point and figure level down here too, I just don't have it on the chart. Okay, I put that number in. It's 127440. So you can see how that level was respected. We hammered and then we reversed. We closed above that for the day and then we saw this nice rally. Moved up almost to 1370, moved back down to another point and figure level, and then moved higher. So these lines that you see on GTO's charts and mine are not arbitrary. They're based on point and figure charts. And the more you study this, the more you understand it, the better your trading is going to become, because not only do you have channels and patterns that you can trade off of, as well as, in this case, an Ichimoku chart where you can see where that level is also respected by the underside of this cloud, that we could very well rally up to the 1432 level and find some more resistance, okay? Which, if we continue to move through this and have a Kumo breakout, we have a very high likelihood that we could trade higher and possibly up to this upper trend line, okay, going into 2013. So if you have any questions about point and figure that I haven't covered, I think I covered pretty much all of it, the summarized version, give me a buzz or leave a comment on this YouTube video down below or ask me a question in the chat. REM Inc. is also good at point and figure charts, as well as GTO and a number of other people. So this is basically just a quick point and figure primer, and what I utilize, as well as some of the other techniques, in order to trade and be ready for areas like this where we saw this reversal. GTO traded some puts the last couple of days and got out of those this morning, and we saw this nice drop down, an exit, and then a hammer into the close. So they're very powerful, and you should use them in your toolbox. Okay? I hope this helps. We'll see you in the chat tomorrow. Take care.